My father and the other four missionaries definitely knew it was dangerous, but they were willing to give up their lives in order for the Waorani to know the truth, what we believe to be the truth. My father arrived in Ecuador in March 1952 to be a missionary to indigenous or primitive tribes in the Amazon jungle. He found out about the Waorani, they used to be known as the Aucas, now the Waorani, through another missionary who had been in Ecuador. This missionary said that the Waorani were very violent, Stone Age, and they knew nothing about the outside world. It just caught his heart, and he felt that those were the people he was supposed to go to. My father and the missionary pilot, Nate Saint, took several flights over the Amazon jungle looking for this group of Indians, and eventually came upon this one very small settlement of the Waorani.
I saw a thing that thrilled me. It seemed an old man stood beside the house and waved with both of his arms as if to signal for us to come down. Aucas waving at me to come.
Nate Saint, the pilot, by that time had found a spit of a beach along the Kurarai River that he knew the Waorani could walk to. These five men decided to set up camp on that little beach. After 3 days of waiting at the camp, there were three Waorani that came out of the jungle, two women and one young man. The joy of the five men was that they were perfectly friendly and there didn't seem to be any hostility at all. But the Waorani were, of course, suspicious of these white men and really had no idea of the goodwill that the white men had for them. They might be deceiving them, they said. They might be tricking us, and we better kill them before they kill us. We believe it was around 3 p.m. 10 men arrived at the Palm Beach, and with their spears, they brutally speared all five of the men and left the bodies in the water. After my father's death, my mother got to know two Waorani women who had fled the tribe because of the violence. And they said, we want you and the sister of Nate Saint, we want you to come and tell our people about God. While we lived with them, and we were there almost 2.5 years, I, of course, got to know all of the tribe and the 10 men who had done the killing. Amazingly, I really don't remember being afraid of them. They were always laughing, and they would always make my mother laugh. So I simply enjoyed being with them.
When passing through,
of course, it was a tragedy, and of course, I often wished that I had known my dad, still do. But I really believe that God allowed this to happen so that more and more people could actually see what real commitment to Christ means. And I really don't believe their lives were wasted.